الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. I welcome you all to yet another episode of ours on a series of talks on the Day of Judgment and the journey of the hereafter with our distinguished and honored guest, Sheikh Dr. Ma'an Kusa. So please help me in welcoming him. Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Kusa, and welcome to our program.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, Abdul Jabbar.
Sheikh, in the previous episode, you were telling us about the Day of Reckoning and how the kuffar will be facing reckoning and accounting. So now let's talk about the believers. How will the believers be reckoned?
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala khayri al-anbiya wal-mursaleen, nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. All praises be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May peace and blessings be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, we mentioned in the previous episode about how the non-believers will be reckoned and accounted for their deeds. Now, as for the believers, when we read through the verses of the Quran and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we can clearly see at least three different styles of reckoning. We have a group of people, yet though it's a small group, of people who pass on that day with no question whatsoever and no punishment. They are directly taken to paradise. We have a second category of believers who would face what is called al-hisab al-yasir, the easy reckoning. And there are others who will face what we call al-niqash, or the interrogation. They will be interrogated and questioned for what they have done.
So, Sheikh, let's first talk about the believers who will face no reckoning whatsoever.
Those are mentioned in one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Yadkhulu ummati 70,000." الجنة بغير حساب ولا عذاب. 70,000 of my nation will enter paradise without any reckoning or any punishment. And the attribute that caused this, that made them deserve or get this reward, is التوكل على الله, their level of trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so great. They trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strongly, and as a reward of that, they will enter paradise without any question or any type of punishment.
Sheikh, you said the second category of the believers facing reckoning would be those who will receive easy reckoning. What is meant by easy reckoning?
In fact, this term, easy reckoning, is what we read in Surah Al-Inshiqaq. فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. Easy reckoning. The explanation of the al-hisab al-yasir we learn from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He explained al-hisab al-yasir as what he called al-ard, which means displaying one's sins. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the day of judgment, for those who are facing al-hisab al-yasir, the easy reckoning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come close to his servant and will display and mention for him his sins. So he will tell him, "You remember you did on that day such and such sin." And the slave would say, "Yes." "And you did such and such on that day." He would say, "Yes." And so on, until all his sins are displayed for him, and this he will admit them all.
This is privately to him.
This is privately. That's, you know, out, that's an easy account. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not disclosing this to others. That's a sort of, you know, appreciation and respect to that to that slave. So he's not, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not disclosing him among all others. So his sins are only mentioned to him. Now, when all these sins are mentioned to him, that man would think that he would definitely be punished. You know, all these sins are there, are recorded, and now he's admitting them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after displaying all these sins, and after this man is admitting them all, would say, إني سترتها عليك في الدنيا. I did not disclose them. I did not expose you in your life. وأني أغفرها لك اليوم, and I forgive you for all of these sins today. So he will be forgiven. This is the الحساب اليسير. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who receive such an easy reckoning. Inshallah.
So Shaykh, now coming to the third category of the believers, you said they'll be interrogated. So what do you mean by interrogation, and what is it?
In that same hadith, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in fact was once talking to Aisha, and he said, من نوقش الحساب هلك. Whoever is questioned, that is given a question and is asked to answer. It's not like a display, you know, the one we had before. It's just, you know, he was mentioned, things were mentioned to him. Now, in this category, he was given a question and he's expected to answer the question. So the Prophet said, whoever is asked in this way will definitely be punished. Then Aisha was confused about this, and she said to the Prophet, but didn't Allah say, فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا? Then the Prophet said, yes, this is referring to the display, the listing of his sins. But if he is asked a question and expecting an answer and a response, that's a sign that this man will be punished. So this is the interrogation style of questioning.
So Shaykh, did he, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, state any specific examples of those who will be interrogated?
Yes, indeed. He taught us many of those. So that we will be aware of these sins, because these are then great sins, because they will cause such tough questioning and reckoning. In one hadith, the Prophet ﷺ gave us an example of three types of people. And in fact, he said that these three are the first three to be thrown in fire. He mentioned a man whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have taught him Quran and gave him the knowledge. In the day of judgment, Allah will ask him, what did you do with the Quran you knew and with the knowledge I provided you? The man would reply, I recited Quran for your sake, and I spread knowledge for your sake. Allah will say, you lied. And the angels will say, you lied. You did so that you'll be praised by people. And they will say, Mashallah, you are a scholar. Mashallah, you are a nice reciter of Quran. This was your intention in doing so. And you got that. People praised you. So you have no reward left for you from us. And then you'll be pushed in fire. Then he mentioned the example of a man whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him wealth. So he was rich. So on the day of judgment, Allah will ask him, what did you do with the wealth and money I gave you, I provided for you? The man would claim that he used it to, you know, to donate for the sake of Allah, to give his relatives for the sake of Allah. Allah will say to him, you lied. And the angels will say, you lied. You spent so that it will be said, Mashallah, he's generous. And you got such a praise you were looking for. So no reward is left for you now. And he will also be pushed in the fire. And finally, he mentioned the example of a man who was killed in a war. When he is brought in front of Allah on the day of judgment, Allah will ask him, what you were killed for? He said, I was killed for your sake. I was fighting for your sake. And I was then killed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, you lied. And the angels will say, you lied. You fought so that they would say, what a brave man he is. So you're looking for the praise from the people. This is what we call an arriya, looking for praises from the people. You're not waiting for my reward. You're not doing it for my sake. And for that, you have no reward for here, and he will be pushed in fire. So these are examples of people who will be questioned and interrogated, and then they will be punished.
So Shaykh, whatever we have talked about till now was about and regarding the people who failed to fulfill their duties towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they disobeyed him, or etc. So now, coming to the people who have wronged other people, for example, in this life, we see some people may oppressing others, beating them or hurting them, etc. So how would these kind of people face reckoning?
That's a very good question. You know, probably one of the main values in believing in the Day of Judgment, to know that any, you know, unjust behavior or oppression people may have in this life would definitely be sorted out later if it's not sorted out in this life. This is why the Day of Judgment is there. So this life is not isolated from the day after. It's in fact a continuation. The Prophet ﷺ then warned us and he said, whoever, من كان له مظلمة عند أخيه فليتحلل منها قبل أن لا يكون دينار ولا درهم. Whoever have wronged his brother by anything, let him pay it now. Let him resolve it now. Let them sort it out now, before a day comes where money exchange would not help. And that day there will be exchange of deeds. So better solve it now and sort it now, because it will be too expensive to sort it later. The Prophet ﷺ once was sitting with his companions and he asked him a question. Do you know who is the bankrupt one, Al-Muflis? They said, we consider the bankrupt one is the one who has no property. No money, you know, no furniture, no house. The Prophet ﷺ said, well, the real bankrupt one of my nation is a man who comes on the Day of Judgment with prayers, fasting, charity, yet he will come and he had insulted someone, beaten someone, stolen someone. So on the Day of Judgment, these people have to get their rights back. In what form? In the form of his good deeds. He has to pay them of his good deeds as in compensation for the wrongdoing he did to them in his life. So he will pay that one from his deeds, and that one from his deeds, and that one from his deeds. Now if his deeds, his good deeds are over, and yet he did not pay it all, then what would happen? He will take from their bad deeds and sins, and will be thrown on him. Then he will end up being a real bankrupt one, who has no good deeds, and only in debt. He has all the bad deeds of himself and of others. This is what the Prophet ﷺ considered the bankrupt one. So it's very serious that one would sort out any wrongdoing in this life and not leave it for the day after, because it's very expensive to sort it then. In that regard, I probably may mention another an interesting or important story. A man came to the Prophet ﷺ and he said, O Prophet of Allah, I have slaves who serve me, but these people betray me, disobey me, and tell me lies. In response to that, I punish them. What would be the situation in the day after? The Prophet ﷺ said, well, when it is in the day after, then their betrayal, their disobedience, and their telling lies will be calculated. How much did they do this to you? And your punishment to them will also be calculated. Now, if it happens that their misdoing to you is over your punishment, then you will still have a credit from them. However, if it's found that your punishment has exceeded their wrongdoing, then they will have a credit that they will take from you. And then the Prophet ﷺ recited the verse, وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا وَإِنْ كَانَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ أَتَيْنَا بِهَا وَكَفَى بِنَا حَاسِبِينَ. That is, we place the just balances on the Day of Judgment, and not a tiny single thing will be wronged. Everybody will take his full rights.
Jazakallahu khairan, Shaykh. That's all we had for this episode. Thank you for sharing all this information with us.
Wa iyyakum inshaAllah. Jazakallahu khair.
So dear brothers and sisters, here was Dr. Ma'an Kusa with us talking about the reckoning and how the believers would be facing reckoning. Please join us in our next episode, where we will be moving ahead in our journey of the hereafter and learn from our Shaykh what happens after the day of reckoning. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.